I am a Windows user, and that is why I will download the Windows application for the iScribe A4 USB digital writing pad. And for that, I am heading to the website of Itronics. So this is the website of Itronics, and I'm navigating to the downloads section and then going to the Windows application download, clicking on it. And now I'm waiting for the software, the zip file, saving it on my desktop. So now I'm just saving it on my desktop, going to the desktop, waiting for the file to download. It has still not downloaded. Let's wait for a few seconds. By the time it downloads, it's still not downloaded. Maybe my net connection is not that fast at this moment. Let me pause the video and come back to you once the download is completed. So now the video has downloaded. Just a moment. Now the video has downloaded. Let's go and extract the files. So now I will extract the files. Open with Pre-Requisite. So this is the folder. I'm extracting it. Now it is extracted. This is the folder by the name of debug. So I'm clicking on debug now. And here there are two files over here. One is the setup file, which is the application, and one is iScribe for you, Windows installer. So now click on this iScribe for you, a Windows installer file. So I'm clicking on that and waiting for the installation to happen. So here it is. Welcome to iScribe for you setup wizard. And I'm clicking on next. I'm just letting the settings be as they are. I'm not changing anything. The installer is ready to install on your computer. Click next to start the installation. So now I'm clicking next. And iScribe for you is being installed. It is asking me to wait. It will take some time for it to install. Let me pause the video and get back to you once the installation is completed. So I'm running the installation file once again. So now it says, do you want to allow the app from an unknown publisher? I'm saying yes. And the installation has finally started. iScribe for you is being installed. iScribe for you has been successfully installed. Click close to exit. Please use Windows update to check for any critical updates to the .NET framework. Okay, so I'm clicking on close, clicking this window, and now there is iScribe for you icon on my desktop. So I'm double clicking on that icon, iScribe for you, and let me see what comes up next. I have already double clicked it and waiting. It says my Norton antivirus has detected some threats. Valid. Don't worry about this, because this is the folder iScribe. Just to make sure that everything is in place, I'm scanning it with Norton itself, with Norton antivirus. So this is the folder, going to Norton security, scan now, and all this is happening live. So this is the folder that I've extracted, and see, it is saying no threats found. See, no threats found over here. So that means it's safe. Same goes for the zip folder. So I'm scanning it once again with Norton security. Norton had warned me of some threats, and I'm scanning the file with Norton 360 itself, and the software is saying no threats found. So don't worry, it is safe. Registration details not found. Click yes if you are a registered user. Click no if you are not a registered user. So now, if you remember, on the Itronics website, they have given a PDF of how to register your product. So let me open that link. So I'm going to Itronics once again, and here I'm navigating to the downloads section. So I went to the download section, and here I'm navigating down to this part of the page, which says serial number register and payment. So serial number registration and text conversion payment. So I'm clicking on download. Actually, it is a PDF, it is not a download. So when I click on that, here they have given the process of how to register your product after you have installed it. So here, after installation, this is the same message which is coming on the screen. Look here, over here, this is the same message. I'll minimize this window. See, this same dialog box is coming over here. So now it says press no to register the serial number. Below registration form will appear. So now I will enter my personal details, which includes my email address, first name, last name, mobile number, device ID, serial number, institution name, state, city. They have given they have filled a sample form over here, and once registered you will get the dialog box. So I will register, and I will pause the video, do the registration, and continue the video after that. Proceed to the registration. I wanted to show you one more thing. This is the dialog box over here. It is asking me, are you a registered user or you are not? So I am not a registered user, so I will click on no. When I click on no, I will get this registration form, and it is asking me to fill all my personal details and register. This is the profile button. If I click on that, nothing is happening. Here I have to fill all my details. So I will be pausing the video, filling the details, and then clicking on register, and then continuing the video. But before that, if I click on cancel, look what happens. If I click on cancel, it says closing the application, please contact Itronics. So that means registration for all USB models is compulsory, right? So let me fill my personal details and continue the video after I fill my details and click on register. Thank you. My iScribe A4 digital USB writing pad to my PC, but for some reason I am not able to, the device is not found. So now what I will, so now I'm heading once again to the Itronics website, and this time I'm going to the downloads section and clicking on the prerequisite library for Windows, because I'm using a Windows machine. If you're using a Mac, or if you are using it on an Android phone, then you won't have to download this. But because I'm using a Windows machine, and my device is not found. So I'm clicking on the prerequisite library and installing it. So I'm now clicking on the download button. Just waiting for the prerequisite library to load. Sorry, the file. So now I'm clicking on save as. And I will be saving it on my desktop. I'm saving it on my desktop and it has already been saved. So minimizing this video, that window. And this is the prerequisite library, zip file. So before we begin, let's scan this with Norton antivirus, Norton security. So scan now. And I'm sure there won't be any issues. So it says no threats found, clicking on finish. And now I'm extracting this zip folder to the desktop. So now I'm clicking on extract now. It will extract the prerequisite library on my computer. Double clicking on the folder. So now this is the Visual C++ folder and I'm double clicking on that. And this is one application which I need to install. So once again, double clicking on that. And this is a dialog box. Do you want to allow this app to make changes? I have said yes. And this is the Visual C++ package which is being installed. So it is saying Microsoft maintenance, please select one of the following, repair, remove. I don't know what to do now, because let me continue with just the way it is. So repair to its original state, remove. So I'm clicking on repair and clicking on next. So when I click on next, it is saying repair in progress. It is installing the necessary environment to use this software. It is saying repair is complete and I'm clicking on finish. I'm clicking on finish and now closing this window. Closing this window and let's see if I can connect it now. So I will fill my personal details and try to connect, register the my product with the company. So coming back soon. So now I have installed the Visual C++, which is the prerequisite library software, filled the form. And now clicking on, I've already connected my device to the computer. So now I'm clicking on register. Let's see if it still says device not found. So I'll be restarting the computer and checking again. Fill the registration form. This registration form, you need to connect your device, which is the iScribe A4 USB pad. You need to give me 1 second. I'll just enlarge the camera. So you need to connect your iScribe A4 digital writing pad to your computer using the USB to micro USB port. So I'll do that in front of you. I'm keeping the iScribe pad over here. Just a minute. So I'm keeping it over here. And this is the place where I need to, there is a micro USB port over here. So you need to connect this micro USB port over here. I've connected that, and now I will connect this USB port to my computer. So as soon as I connect it, you will see there is a blue light. And now you need to fill this form and click on register. See you soon. One important thing I wanted to mention. So now it is saying, it is asking me to configure as soon as I completed the registration. So as soon as I have completed the registration, it is asking me to create an output folder. So I am about to do that now. Select the output source folder. So now I have successfully created an output folder. This is the one. This is the output folder.